Good evening, I'm Dennis Ward, and this is Face to Face.
Our guest this week is Clarence Iron. Iron is a member of Canoe Lake Cree Nation and a resident of Pinehouse Lake. He had a challenging upbringing and is a residential school survivor. Last year, he helped make history. Iron was the play-by-play announcer for the first ever Rogers hometown hockey in Cree on APTN. He's recently announced that Iron has signed a three-year deal with Rogers to continue to provide play-by-play for Rogers hometown hockey in Cree on APTN.
It happened. My dream came true. But to call it in Cree, I never thought. I thought I'd do it in English because I called a lot of English hockey games before. But for to do the Cree, you know, it, even myself, sometimes I amaze myself.
Yeah. Clarence, thanks so much for joining us and congrats on your new contract. Mm-hmm. What does that three-year deal mean for yourself?
Well, it means a lot to me because you know, a lot of people are excited. I am excited. Especially that the one that we did, people, we had a good response. So it's going to be, you know, people are waiting to listen. As a matter of fact, just before I left, I had some calls and also on Facebook, mm-hmm. Congratulating me, and they're saying that we're going to be listening.
Yeah. How excited were you to hear that there were going to be more games after, you know, calling that historic game last season?
Yeah, when they mentioned it, that it's possible that there was going to be more games, and I thought, well, in the back of my mind, I thought maybe that's just that one game, and that's it. But, you know, but there was still that, we were still hoping through negotiations. I was talking to Doug there off and on, and then all of a sudden it went through. So, you know, I'm excited, yeah.
When I've interviewed you in the past, you said calling that game, the NHL game, was a lifelong dream fulfilled for yourself. I assume you grew up with a love of the game?
I used to play junior hockey, too. When we never got scouted till I was almost 20 years old. I was good enough. If I would have been scouted a little earlier, you know, I made it as far as junior A hockey, which is pretty good. I played with some NHL players that were on my line. Mm-hmm. Yeah, one of them is Alan Conroy. Al Conroy, he ended up playing for Philadelphia Flyers, and maybe he's probably listening right now. He did give me a call, but I was on his line. We were on the same team, you know, but I was scouted a little too late. Same thing with this NHL, you know. In my prime, when I was younger, you know, that's when I was right into it. But even right now, yeah, I'm excited now that it's happening.
Never too late to...
It's never too late. Yeah, that's the thing. But I retired for a while from radio, media and stuff. Yeah, I had retired for about 10 years. I worked in the mines in northern Saskatchewan, and I worked in the oil and gas industry in north of Fort McMurray and also north of Cold Lake, called Foster Creek. So I'm jack of all trades. I can do pretty much anything. I was a phys ed instructor too. Yeah.
You feel all those other jobs as well as your media training play into this role?
Oh yeah, yeah. Everything. It comes. You know, meeting other people. I met professionals. I got involved with the games as well, the North American Indigenous mm-hmm. Games. I called a professional boxing bout, and that was in Regina.
This would have been exciting to watch. Clarence, you know, you're a residential school survivor. How difficult was it for you to retain your language over the years?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, it's... I kept my language. I used to tell them, I used to speak to myself. You know, I lived in Thunder Bay for a bit. I was in another place where there was hardly any Cree spoken mm-hmm. or the language, but I spoke to myself. That's how I kept my language alive.
It looks like a new
You know, like I just, it sounds crazy, but you know, if I was going to go buy something in a store, well, I'll speak to myself. Yeah, just like as if I'm talking to somebody. Igwa, atawagam gukto titan, doa tawitan, you know, like I'd speak to myself, and that's how I kept it alive. But in a residential school, I remember most of the students were losing their language. Mm-hmm. Yeah, most of them. But see, I've seen the four stages, three or four stages of the residential school. When I got in there, I seen 1 year of the nuns and the priests. They were just phasing out. And then came the Northern Affairs, Indian Affairs, they used to call them. Indian Affairs ran that school. And then the next phase, I seen the tribal council ran it. And then I think it was run by First Nations, and it phased out in the 80s, 84, 85, 86, somewhere around there, where I went anyways, Bow Valley Indian Residential School. Yeah, but I seen all the phases of how it was. I wasn't really in that when the priests and the nuns were operating it. I was right at the end of that era. But I did. But I seen it when I was living on the reserve. Mm-hmm. Not at the residential school, because they used to come to our reserve. They used to bring us some skates and stuff like that from the residential school, stuff that handed down stuff, and they used to bring it on the reserve for the kids to use, some hockey equipment, because right. Canoe Lake, Bow Valley, it's not too far. It's only about 20 miles.
Clarence, what's your hope with these games and what it might be able to do for Plains Cree?
You know, this is going to really lift up the language. I know for a fact, even the kids, where I come from, yeah, they know who I am. And so, hey, Tiboy, that's my nickname. Tiboy, when are you going to call the hockey game again, you know? Yeah, they're excited, and they always want me to speak that, the Cree. Yeah, hippopotamus is one of those words that they like when I say it in Cree. Elephant, a bunch of little different stuff that I describe, because you're kind of describing the animal itself. Mm-hmm. Yeah, just like the hippopotamus is. Piagogis chimtata tum tanogisugatuatam piugis pagasayuni sopitu makitunugukus. And then the elephant is chimsuganiu makihtawagayukinugut. So those, when I say that real fast, they really enjoy that, the kids, yeah.
Me too, I can see why they would.
Yeah, and they get excited, and they ask me all the time, even in hockey. When I was calling hockey, like I said, I was never in a box. I was right in the crowd right there, because we had the equipment there. They never allowed us to use the... Until in North Battleford, finally, we used a box. Yeah, North Battleford, Prince Albert, Meadow Lake. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but before we were just sitting right amongst the fans, right here, sitting here, and I'm calling the hockey game, and I had the crowd behind me here, the kids, and they liked what I was calling that hockey.
Clarence, how does that make you feel, you know, to have these young kids come up to you and ask you to speak to them in Cree?
Oh, you know, it's I'm excited. You know, I try to help them out. When they ask questions, like I say, if they want to know more about the Cree. And I even tell them, you kids, you know, try and learn Cree at home, because, you know, their parents are still good Cree speakers. Mm-hmm. And all they need is to learn it. And maybe I tell them, maybe one of these days you'll be in the studios like right here. You'll be calling a NHL game or any type of a sport, even football. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I called football too in Cree. Yeah, in Cree. I tried every sport that I could, but that's not on TV, but radio.
Right.
Yeah, radio, because our radio is not there's no commercials. It's operated by the community itself. So anything goes, wherever. So I'm just running around the field. There again, there's no place to sit. So if it's on the 40-yard line, I'm right there. Mm-hmm. I'm running with my equipment, and I'm calling the play.
Yeah, we all know the importance of those community stations.
Yeah.
Clarence, we're going to have to just step aside for a quick break, and then we'll continue the conversation here on Face to Face with play-by-play announcer Clarence Iron. Welcome back to Face to Face. Our guest this week is Clarence Iron, the play-by-play announcer for Rogers Hometown Hockey in Cree on APTN. And Clarence, maybe if you could let us in on how do you prepare for these games?
You know, I don't even know. No, you know, actually everything is on, I go to a certain team, say like, well, Winnipeg here, Winnipeg and Chicago, mm-hmm. I go into their lineup, and every there's the name of the player and the number is there. So well, you have to study the name, the numbers, and there is a lineup each night. So I get to study all the names, the numbers, but then at times when the game is on, the regular lineup, it's not going to be the same all the time, mm-hmm. because there's injuries.
Right.
Yeah, right now I think there's 5 or 6 injuries for Winnipeg. The ones that I studied in the first month,
yeah.
Well, they're not playing now. They're being injured. So there's new ones that are coming in. So you have to try and know the whole team. Yeah, all the players and their numbers. And it takes a little skill.
Oh, no kidding. Yeah, that's a lot to keep in your mind there.
Yeah, a lot. So, but I keep in touch with what's happening. So, but it's all on computer. I look at it all the time, the injuries, who's going to be playing that night.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's a little easier with the computer now, not like before.
This was something that came up when APTN did the Olympics, was, you know, the fact that there aren't words in languages for mm-hmm. certain plays or calls. Was this something for yourself in Plains Cree that you had to almost create or consult to come up with words for certain plays or movements?
Yeah, you have to see, just like not too long ago here, but back in 2010, the curling.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they had to come up with some words. There was no word for curling.
Right.
Yeah, and I was just talking to a friend of mine that did that, the curling part of things. Even that, you know, it makes sense now if you really think about it. So squasiniu mi tawiwan, that's curling, the game curling. So squasiniu mi tawiwan. But if you were to describe that curling, it's so skupaihu, asini musiniwi pahigiu mi tawiwan. You were describing the movement of the curling. Yeah.
It was exciting for Indigenous mm-hmm. and non-Indigenous people to watch that first game. What was the reaction that you were hearing?
Oh, they were excited, especially with, like you said, with the words that we were practicing with, even the puck itself, you know. There was a few names thrown around, you know, for the puck, because mm-hmm. lots of stuff were being used back then, you know, horse manure. You
right,
know,
yeah.
Rock is something that's solid, and you know, because they had no rubber pucks, well, in our area, anyways.
Yeah.
So they were describing that puck there. Napaguan is something that's flat and round. Napaguan is, but if you were to describe that puck, kawawi sitsun squipaigan is kagas kitsisit, piagmitsichin kagis pagisit. You're describing that rubber puck. So, you know, these are the words that we started putting together. Even the net itself, you know, the net. Mm-hmm. Well, what do you call the net? Well, in Waska, skinigan is something like the trappers used to go and set a trap. So they used to put a bunch of sticks on a tree, and, you know, they call it Waska skiniganis. And then they used to put the trap right there. So, but there, you know, this Waska skinigan is something that's closed in, but there's a net on it. So it was called Skinnigan Ayapi. Ayapi means net. Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, if it's an N dialect, it's Anapi, Arapi, Arapi. There's different dialects in Cree. But our language, we say Ayapi. Ayapi Waska Skinnigan. That's the gold net. Ayapi Waska Skinnigan. Well, we made that up. Well, but it's everybody's picking it up and they're starting to understand it. So the words, like you said, yeah, you know, some words we have to come up with, and some were there before.
Right.
Yeah. So your question too, as well, the one you were asking me there,
the excitement from non-Indigenous people as well.
Yeah,
watching
I heard some of the people that didn't never heard. They didn't understand the language at mm-hmm. all, but they said they were watching the game, they were listening to it. They didn't understand what was being said, but they say they could feel something. It got them excited, and they decided to watch the whole game. Yeah.
I heard that from some people. Clarence, mm-hmm. we do have to step aside for one more quick break, but then we will continue the conversation mm-hmm. here with play-by-play announcer Clarence Iron on Face to Face. Welcome back to Face to Face. Our guest this week is Clarence Iron, the play-by-play announcer for Rogers Hometown Hockey in Cree on APTN. Clarence, you've overcome many challenges in your own life. What advice do you have for those out there who are looking to follow their dream like you did?
You know, I told a story here not too long ago. Like, I had a rough life upbringing. Yeah, and some I did it to myself. Like, I was roughing it in life, but then I was given a new life. That mm-hmm. I was trying to pass that message on, that new life that I was given. Because I got involved with alcohol, drugs, and everything. I lived off the streets, and, you know, but I knew how to survive out in the back home. Mm-hmm. Yeah, like where I live right now, Pine House, well, you know, I can live off the land and also in the city life. I lived in a city as well. But anyways, I've been given a new life, but right now I wouldn't be sitting here. You know, I'd probably be 6 feet under the ground. You know, and whoever is listening there knows me. You know, I was there. I was just walking out here, and I've seen a lot of these people like begging for nickels and dimes. While I was there, I've seen that rough life, mm-hmm. being an alcoholic, and you know, it all stemmed back when I was younger and going into residential school, and you know, there was so. But I understand now that life. Yeah, now I've changed my life around. I've quit drinking. I've let go of drugs and alcohol and everything, and given this opportunity, you know, I'm there. That's why I'm, you know, that's why I'm here. Yeah, and I want to try and do a good job in whatever I do. But before, I don't think I would have been here. Everybody had counted me out already. You know, people would, as soon as they see me on the streets, they'll take off. They'll walk around me. Mm. And if somebody seen, oh, here comes Chiboy. You know, people were saying that. But when they see me now that I have changed, and people come and see me now, Chiboy, I'm proud of you for what you have done. You know, I used to avoid you. That's what they told me. I used to avoid you. When I seen you coming, I knew you were going to borrow money or, you know, something like that. Mm-hmm. You know, living that life on the streets. But, you know, I've tried everything. That's why I said I'm jack of all trades. I taught phys ed. I'm educated. But yet that alcohol and drugs took me away from those, you know. But now I'm back to the good, given a new life. I go to church and I believe in my God, who I believe. I pray and we have our own church now. I read the Bible every day. My God is the Lord Jesus Christ. I put him in front all the time. Even before I go on radio or anything, I say, Lord, you know, show me. And that's the confidence that I have. And I'm not scared to go on radio and how I look. And everybody makes mistakes. Nobody's perfect. You know, and I'm not scared to tell the people where I was. They've seen me. They've seen me where I was. I ended up in jail lots of times in my time. So, you know, I was just battling it out in life. Now I feel that peace now, the peace that God has given me. And I just feel relaxed now, you know, and I don't need to run around all over to go hide and to take drugs or anything like that. And that's what we're trying to teach these kids too, you know, to stay in school, get educated, and look, and because there's lots of opportunities out there now. You know, not like in our time, there was hardly anything. I didn't even know there was other opportunities out there. The only thing I knew was to be a carpenter, a teacher, and a policeman. That's it back then. But now there's lots of opportunities. And one of them is this. If you can speak the Cree language, right now the language is being raised up. You know, everybody's excited with the... Not only the Cree, I'm talking about the Aboriginal languages. It's right. Good to hear your own people speaking it. It's alive, you know, and that the language, God gave us that language. And we're supposed to be proud to speak it. And, you know, my parents, for example, you know, I'm actually, to be honest, I'm a Métis in a way. My mom's side of their family are all Métis. My dad's side are just strictly the Cree, First Nations. So, you know, that's why everybody think, well, this guy's a white guy here speaking good Cree. But the reason why is because I was raised by my grandparents. And I little did I know that they were illiterate. Even that is another story in itself. My grandparents, they spoke the Cree language all the time. Cree, 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 every day. So when I first went to the school, I remember I brought homework. Well, I figured my grandpa's going to help me out. I'm stuck. You know, I showed him my homework, and he didn't... He couldn't help me out, you know, and I thought, well, how come my grandpa's not helping me out? Well, little did I know he was illiterate, too. You know, he couldn't speak the English or read. But that's where I picked up this Cree, was because when I was younger, my grandpa, my grandma, that's all they spoke, the Cree language. So there, you know, to think back now, you know, I'm very grateful. Because I don't know where I'd be right now, even with that language, you know. But I try everything. That's why I call myself Jack of all trades. I try everything, and you know, though I succeed in some and some I don't. But you know, now I know not to be scared. Yeah.
Well, Clarence, we're glad you're not, and you are an inspiration for many out there, and. Unfortunately, that is all the time we have with you today, but congrats again on the contract and looking forward to hearing you and watching you over the next 3 years. That is all the time we do have for the show today. We're always looking for new guests, so if you have any suggestions, please email us at news@aptn.ca. This show and past episodes are available as podcasts, and you can find those at aptnnews.ca/facetofacepodcast. I'm Dennis Ward. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next week.